The ultimate goal for most of the people is to be successful. And to be successful, we need two things. First is to get a chance, and second is to perform when you get a chance, which is dependent on your experience, education, and the soft skills you have. Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Shirin Talwar, an image enhancer and a soft skills trainer. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about the first point, which is to get a chance. How one can get a chance, what all do you need to get that chance, and how to have that impactful impression so that you are given that chance. Have you ever wondered that even after studying for 20 long years, you still have to sit for that job interview to get that job? For most part of my life, I had this contradiction in my mind whether or not the first impression is a lasting impression or not. In some cases, it is, and in some cases, it is not. It is scientifically proven that in a few seconds of meeting, people decide everything about you. Your authority, confidence, trustworthiness, financial status, candidature for the job promotion, everything. If I still have to convince you further, you may have a look at these examples. If you have to go to a doctor, which one would you go for? The left one or the right one? Or if you have to go to a tattoo artist, which one would you go to? Of course, the left one. Okay, now tell me who looks more like a therapist, left or right? Of course, the left one. Which food would you eat if you're given two options? Of course, the right one. So these were just the examples as to how we're conditioned to look at things. You cannot not communicate, and especially visual communication is not a choice, and do not take me wrong. It doesn't mean that you have to spend a fortune to look good or you have to be fashionable all the time. It just means we have to look put together and well polished. So before I begin with the points that will make you look more put together, confident and well polished, if you're new to my channel, make sure you subscribe to it and give this video a big thumbs up after watching it if you really like it. The first point is your body language. There have been endless studies about body language, and I'll be mentioning a few of them for you to view in the description box below. The quick tip is to have a straight back and a head held higher and have a firm handshake. According to the body language study, the high power poses are having broadened shoulders, which will make you look more alert and confident, having a gentle and simple eye contact with the person you're talking to or the audience you're addressing. And the low power poses are having slopey and droopy shoulders, which will make you look timid, nervous and unconfident, not being able to make eye contact or looking down. Also, constantly touching your neck. Now it's up to you how you want to be perceived as. The next point is to have a genuine and subtle smile. It doesn't mean that you have to enter the room with having a broad, widening smile. It just means having the real and winning smile. Being a fashion stylist and an image enhancer myself, this has to be my favorite point, which is to look presentable, well-groomed, and keeping your hygiene intact. Wearing the clothes that fit you well, which are not oversized or too tight to your body. Having wrinkled clothes, dirty shoes, and chapped lips are the signs of poor hygiene. Now, there are three endings of our body. One is our head, our nails, our fingers, and our toes. So it's important that we keep these three endings well intact. For our head, it doesn't mean that we have to blow dry our hair on a regular basis. Even if you're having a bad hair day, just make sure that your hair looks neat. And for our hands, it's important to have clean nails. Like, I don't have nail extensions or any nail paint, but I've made sure that my nails are trimmed properly. For our shoes, we need to keep in mind that they are not dirty, they are clean and proper. The next point is verbal communication, which is introducing yourself. It is not at all pleasing to see someone take a lot of time to introduce themselves, even though that's the very basic thing. Also, avoid giving one word answers. For example, what do you do? Doctor. Or what do you do? I'm a stylist. So it leads to a very close-ended conversation. Last point and not the least, and as cliche as it sounds, is to be yourself. And to be yourself, you need to know yourself. Have you ever been into a situation where you just feel somebody's presence so strong that no matter what they're wearing, no matter how they're groomed, you just cannot take your eyes off them. That is why it is very important to be comfortable in your own skin, knowing ourselves, knowing our personal colors, knowing our face shape, knowing our body type. Everything helps in enhancing our personal style and bring that gravitas in our personality. So that's it for today's video. I hope you all found it useful and helpful. Also, let me know in the comment section below what is your takeaway and what all points you would like to add on having a lasting and impactful first impression. If you have any questions, feel free to email me or connect with me on my Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook, wherever you feel comfortable. So see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye bye.